first of all, I'd like to thank Sheila Harity for having us here at Worcester Tech, a beautiful, beautiful rehearsal space and performance venue. I would also like to, yes. And I would also like to thank your illustrious principals, Worcester Arts Magnet, Dr. Susan O'Neill. Burncoat Middle School, Lisa Houlihan. And last but not least, the Burncoat High School, Will Foley. And I also want to thank you, the parents, the students, the teachers, everyone who's had a hand in bringing these children forward. You know, this is a very unique situation that you have a fine arts magnet program, three individual schools that offer education, not only superb education in a well-rounded atmosphere, but also education in the arts. It gives your child a wonderful opportunity to explore the arts, something that they will have at their grasp for the rest of their life. You know, they go out to shows, they go to the Hanover, the group is going to New York in the spring. They're exposed to people who come into the schools to show them master classes. These are all things that a lot of the high schools and the elementary schools don't have the opportunity, but your children do have this opportunity, and I know that you appreciate it, and I know this is going to stand them in good stead for the rest of their life. Thank you very much for sharing with us. So we're going to open tonight with the Worcester Arts Magnet Orchestra. It's a group of 24 students. Many of them, this is their first year with an instrument. They are doing a terrific job with their teachers. I also want to mention that you're going to see them several in different costumes. And the reason is they not only play an instrument, but they act and they also dance. So you'll see them later on in the show. So let's open with the Worcester Arts Magnet Orchestra. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next on our program, we have the Worcester Arts Magnet Theater. It's a group of fourth graders who belong to a drama club, and they meet every Wednesday from 7:30 in the morning to 8:15. And they have prepared for you tonight a special adaptation of The Midnight Ride of Paul Revere. Let me share a little secret with you. When the students were ready to go on stage, we had offered them body mics. And you know what these little ones said? We're not babies. We can talk loud. We don't need a body mic. So you're going to see some real grown-ups now. Thank you very much.
Listen, my children, and you shall hear
The Midnight Ride of Paul Revere. On the 18th of April in 75, hardly a man is now alive who remembers that famous day and year.
If British soldiers come by land or sea, hang a lantern high for all to see. Hang one lantern if they come by land, and two lanterns if they come by sea.
One if by land and two if by sea?
Yes.
I know where I can signal you, Paul. From the Old North Church, it's very tall.
Yes, and I on the opposite shore will be. I'll be ready to ride and spread the alarm to every Middlesex village and farm. I'll ride like the wind at top speed and saddle. All must be warned and make ready to battle. Good night.
Good night.
Then with muffled oar, Paul silently rode to the Charlestown shore.
Just as the moon rose over the bay, tide and wind rose on the water lay.
The summer set.
A British ship!
Meanwhile, Paul Revere's friend in the street wanders and watches with eager ears.
Till in the silence around him he hears.
Listen, it's the sound of arms and a tramp of feet. It's the British and they're marching to their boat down the street.
One, two, three, hop. One, two, three, hop.
The Old North Church.
So we climb the tower of the Old North Church by the wind stairs and stealthy treads to the Delphi chamber overhead.
He scared the pigeons off their perch, opened the shutters, and began his search.
But he waited a moment to listen and look down at the moonlight flowing all over the town.
Ooh, look, the moonlight flowing all over the town. It's so beautiful. But, oh, what's that? What's that where the river meets a bay? A line of black that bobs and floats? It's the British and lots of tiny boats!
It's the British and lots of tiny boats!
Mostly he watched with eager search to the belfry tower of the Old North Church.
He could see it above, the graves on the hill.
Lonely and spectral
and somber
and still.
And lo, there on the belfry's height, a glimmer, there's a gleam of light.
He sprang to his saddle, the bridle he turned.
But he waited one moment till full on his sight.
A second lamp in the belfry burns.
A second lamp in the belfry burns. They're coming by sea. I must ride.
A hurry of hopes in the village street.
His shape in the moonlight flying fearless and fleet.
That was all.
And yet through the hazily moonlight,
the fate of our nation was riding that night.
The fate of our nation was riding that night.
It was won by the village clock when he crossed the bridge into Exeter.
degrees.
Who at the bridge would be first to fall?
Who at the bridge would be first to fall? Who that day would be lying dead, kissed by a British musket ball?
Whose son would lay wounded? Whose husband left dead? Four fell on that night, both sides both be shed. You know the rest in the books you have read.
How the British regulars fired and fled.
How the farmers gave them ball for ball, but behind the fence and farmyard wall, chasing the redcoats down the lane and crossing the fields to fight again.
Did you hear them? No babies? That's right. No babies in that group. I loved it. They're so enthusiastic, and their rehearsal was just as good as that, and their show tonight was even better. So thank you very much. What a great audience. Thank you. Our next performance is going to be the Worcester Arts Magnus Select Chorus and Dance. There are 43 of these students. They're fifth and sixth graders, and they actually have to audition to be in this group. They come early three times a week, from 7:30 to 8:15 in the morning. They have also performed at the State House, and they've performed for First Night Worcester. They have won silver and gold medals, and they are the youngest of the show choirs that go to these select festivals. They have won, as I said, they've won many awards. They've been the youngest, and you'll see why they're so outstanding. One of the comments that the judges wrote on their review was that they had outstanding vocal technique and choreography. So let's bring Newsies forward with the Worcester Arts Magnet Select Chorus and Dance.
Thank you. folks, we finally got a headline. Newsies crushed as bulls attack. Grudgy's calling me dumb crips, just too darn slow. Guys are fighting, bleeding, falling. Thanks to good old Captain Jack. Captain Jack just wants to close his eyes and go.
Sleeping.
they could be on Broadway. It was fantastic. Fantastic. And the show that I saw, they only had about 12 boys. Can you imagine the singing and the choreography for that many students on stage? What a terrific job they did. Okay, so next, now we're going to do theater. We have the Burncoat Middle School and the Burncoat High School, and they're going to do an excerpt from A Christmas Story. Now, you can see the full production this next coming weekend, November 21, 22, and 23, at the Burncoat Middle School Auditorium. And maybe next year, if we're lucky, we can put on a show at the Burncoat High School Auditorium. That would be great, wouldn't it? Okay, so this is a great little story. This is a narrator who looks back at himself when he was 9 years old, and he lives in rural Indiana, and he can only think about this one thing that he wants for Christmas. And of course, being a boy, I'll tell you what Ralphie wants. He wants, I have to read this because it's very long, he wants an official Red Ryder carbon action 200 shot range model air rifle. Now, of course, his mother doesn't want him to get it because she's afraid he'll shoot his eye out. But you know, boys, this has a clock and a compass in the stock. This is something he really wants for Christmas. So let's see how his life is back in 1930 rural Indiana. Okay, Ralphie, take it away. A Christmas Story.
Tis the holiday season, and Christmas fever is upon us. Windows are garlanded in red and green, yards are alight with plastic reindeer, and milling crowds of shoppers fill the streets, stores, and malls. I put up my tree last week. I had to assemble it first. Then I threw an artificial Yule log on the propane-augmented fire and began to reminisce about Christmases past. The holidays tend to do that. I found myself remembering another Christmas, in another time, another place. And there it is, the house on Cleveland Street in Homan, Indiana, where I spent the festering years of my childhood. Yes, sir, Homan, Indiana. Ragged vacant lots, American Legion halls, and bowling alleys all woven together in a compact web of high tension wires, telephone lines, and sewer pipes. This time every year, the wind would come screaming over frozen Lake Michigan, laying down great drifts of snow. The air would crack and sing, and power lines creak under caked ice. Christmas was on its way. Lovely, beautiful, glorious Christmas, around which the entire kid year evolved.
Hey,
Flick and Schwartz, my two best friends.
Hey, have you started your Christmas shopping yet?
Got most of it finished.
Man, you're done early. What'd you get?
Come over here.
To us kids, the most important thing, next to what am I getting for Christmas, was what am I getting my parents for Christmas. The selection of presents was done with greater secrecy than a State Department spy operation.
I haven't figured out what to get for my mother yet. For my father. What'd you get him?
Hey, that's my son!
For my father, I got.
Oh, man.
A new flip gun. The sheer creative brilliance of it was staggering. In the land of the rolled-up newspaper and wire fly swatter, the man with the flit gun was king.
You know I'm gonna get my father?
What?
A rose that squirts.
Wow!
We'd all seen these magnificent appliances at Pulaski's candy store before. Bright red celluloid with a rubber bulb for pocket use. A gift anyone would treasure. Preparing for school during a northern Indiana winter was like getting ready for extended deep-sea diving. Long johns, 3 pairs of socks, high tops, overshoes, corduroy knickers, flannel lumberjack shirt, 4 sweaters, fleece-lined leatherette, sheepskin coat, gloves, mittens over the gloves, stocking cap, ear flap hat over the stocking cap, and a scarf wound around and around until only the faint glint of 2 eyes peering out of a mound of moving dry goods told you that there was a kid in there, somewhere.
Ralphie, hurry, you'll be late for school! Ralphie!
I can't put my
thumbs down.
You can just put them down when we get to school. Ready to go?
Uh-huh.
I gotta go wee-wee.
Later, Randy, come on.
It was time. My mother would pull open the door, fighting the wind as it raked its icy fury across the carpet. And then we were launched like astronauts into frigid space, the airlock instantly sealing behind us. Scattered out over the icy wasteland, we leaned into the wind, tiny befurred jots of humanity, disguised as quilted bowling balls with feet, toiling across the tundra, waddling under the weight of frost-covered clothing, moving onward, ever onward, to Warren G. Harding School.
Oh, I'm falling, I can't get up!
Stay here, you're right back.
It never occurred to us to stay home from school. Not even during storms that would have driven lesser creatures in other states to stay inside and dine on their immediate families.
Come on, Randy.
Come on, get his arms.
Winter weather was just something we accepted, like oxygen, gravity, parents, oh, and bullies. Every neighborhood had them. The lines were clearly drawn, like a kid caste system. You were either a bully, a toady, or one of the nameless rabble of victims. The bully of legend in Homan, Indiana was Scut Farkas. Scut Farkas, what a rotten name. What kind of parents would name their kid Scut? Still, I have to admit, the name fit him. He was a wiry, malevolent, sneevily, snively bully. His lips curled cruelly over green teeth, and he had yellow eyes. So help me God, yellow eyes! Every kid I knew was afraid of Scut Farkas. If he was ever nice to you, so much as said hi to you, you dared to feel safe and warm inside. But mostly, he just hit you in the mouth. Randy lay there like a slug. It was his only defense. At one time or another, Farkas treated every kid in the class to a good, brisk, tendon-snapping arm twist. He gave us this refresher course on a rotating basis. We figured he kept a list and checked us off in turn. But Flick caught it from Farkas more often than any of the rest of us.
My arm!
Flick's arm was always sore. There was never enough healing time between sessions with Farkas.
Ow, ow, ow!
Fortunately, Flick was left-handed.
Say, I'm a dirty little chicken! Say it! Say it!
I'm a dirty little chicken!
What?
I'm a dirty little chicken!
Whoa!
I'm a dirty little chicken!
Fly away, chicken!
See what I mean about Punjab? Bully problem solved. Every day at recess, a select group of us gathered around the lamppost in the corner of the playground to discuss the deep philosophers and share insight based on the latest research.
Oh yeah?
Yeah!
Alright, then I double dare ya.
The exact exchange and nuance of wording in this phase of the dare ritual was very important.
So you're saying if I put my tongue on this pole, it'll stick?
Yeah.
That's dumb, it wouldn't happen.
Then go ahead, prove me I'm wrong.
Yeah, do it, Flip.
Come on.
Heck no.
Because you know it would stick.
Would not.
Would two?
Would not.
Would two?
Would not.
Arthur, I double dog dare ya.
This was getting serious. A double dog dare? All that was left now was a triple dare, and finally, the coup de grace of all dares, the sinister triple dog dare.
I triple dog dare, yeah!
All right.
Go on, smart pants, do it!
Yeah, do it, Flick!
Hey, that's my sore arm!
Do it!
Don't rush me!
Flick's spine stiffened. His lips curled into a defiant sneer. His tongue went into docking mode, and he moved towards consummation.
This is...
Jeepers, it really worked!
Hey, wait, what are we gonna do?
Oh, no, the bell rang!
We lived by the bell. It told us when to go in, when to go to recess, when to go home. It was the word of God, and could not be denied.
good writer and the dog is a very good book. I enjoyed it very much.
Thank you, Helen. That was a fine book report.
Thank you, Michio.
Helen Weathers was a woman ahead of her time. To this day, there are only 3 scientists in the world who understand her third grade science fair project. We boys all respected her. She had demonstrated on more than one occasion that she could beat us up.
Okay, let's see who is next. Ralph, would you please read your book report? Wait a minute. Where's Flick?
Uh-oh.
Has anyone seen Flick?
Flick? Flick who?
Ralph, I know that he was here before recess. For the last time now, I am asking, has anyone seen Flick? Yes, Esther Jane. You stay right here!
Hi, Ralphie.
Hi.
Oh my God!
Flick drew quite a crowd. First Miss Shields, then the principal, the fire department, and 2 police cars. Somebody even called the power company. They all stood around discussing theories until finally somebody stepped forward, grabbed Flick, and pulled. Freedom has its price.
Now, I know that some of you have put Flick up to this. Unfortunately, he refuses to say who. But I am sure that the guilt you feel is far worse than any punishment that I can give. Now, those who've done it, don't you feel terrible? Don't you feel remorse for what you've done? Anyways, that's all I'm going to say. Flick? You're welcome. You may take your seat.
The guilt you feel is far worse than any punishment you might receive. Adults love to say things like that, but kids know the real truth. It's way better not to get caught. On Saturday, Flick, Schwartz, and I would head down to Pulaski's candy store. We were connoisseurs of the root beer barrel, Juju Baby, and licorice pipe, so we could spend hours making our selections. Then maybe we'd head over to the Orpheum to ride the ranges with Roy, Gene, and Hoppy. Sunday was always family day. In the afternoon, we would pile into the Oldsmobile and park downtown to watch the people go by, a ritual that never ceased to entertain the old man. And on Monday, the cycle began all over again. Tuesday, and stores were beginning to stay open nights, which meant things were getting serious. On Wednesday, I drifted home from school, secure in the knowledge that my plan was progressing. First, the barrage of BB gun ads, and second, Mrs. Shields' endorsement. And the final piece of the puzzle would fall into place that very evening.
Everyone ready?
Ready.
Where's Ralph?
He's already in the car.
Not too anxious, is he? Well, let's get a move on.
Don't want to waste electricity.
Oh no, don't want to waste electricity.
Tonight was the night of the great annual pilgrimage, when the family piled into the Oldsmobile, and we headed down to...
I don't know where we're going.
And we went to Goldblatt's department store, where we would mix with crowds of shoppers, parents driving herds of tired and whiny children. Parents driving herds of children, floor to floor, aisle to aisle, department to department, cuffing, spanking, threatening, for the love of... Finally, at Goldblatt's, I would make contact with the final team member, seated on a snowy throne, under a squadron of plastic angels. The man, the connection, the godfather himself, Santa Claus. That BB gun would be mine. Be sure to catch the rest of Christmas Story on November 21st to 23rd at the Burncoat Middle School Auditorium.
well-oiled machine back there. Every one of those students know exactly where they're supposed to be and when to go on. There's no direction going on back there. These students know their job and they do it very well. Okay, so next we have the Burncoat Middle School Chorus, followed by the Burncoat Middle School Band. The chorus will do a medley of songs from Disney. And what show about the Oscars would not feature a Disney medley? These group of 7th and 8th graders, they are from the Magnet program and also the Enrichment program. Now with the band, they are going to do an ensemble of music from Sound of Music. I found myself singing along with them, so if you feel so inclined, just do it quietly because you really haven't auditioned for this, okay? So anyway, we're going to start with the chorus first, and then we're going to follow up with the band. And this is a requirement for instrumental music students to be part of this band, but it's also open to all the woodwind, brass, and percussion students who do attend Burncoat Middle School. So enjoy. Thank you.
Percussion.
Strings. Winds.
Yeah.
here on the ocean floor.
Such wonderful things around you.
What more are you looking for?
Under the sea, under the sea. Darling is better, downer is wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore they work all day. Out in the sun they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating.
Okay, here I am, the filler. I'm going to fill in for a minute. We have a wonderful treat for you tonight. We have the Burncoat Middle School under the direction of Mr. Levesque, and he is going to perform a medley of songs for you. Very talented students. He has a very talented son, which you'll see later on. But it's a wonderful group. They're just getting together now. And let's see. Oh, I know. I was going to tell you a little something I didn't think you know. You know, I'd normally know what year I hosted the show by what I wore. So I said, oh yes, that was the second year I wore the black outfit. Yes, on the first show I wore the green outfit. Well, anyway, this year I had this wonderful dress. It was black, it was long, it was a slit up the side. And then Angelina Jolie called and she wanted to borrow it. What could I say? I'm a trooper. Okay, here we go. Here's the orchestra. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, hold on to your seats. We have a really great performance now. We haven't had any dance yet, except for our select chorus, but now we're just going to feature the dancers. This is the Burncoat Dance Team under the direction of Joan Ashiri and Kelly Shea. They are going to do a great show tonight for you. They're going to do a scene from Annie, Let's Go to the Movies, how appropriate. And then they're going to do some excerpts from the Michael Jackson tour, Just Do It. I think you're going to love that. And then we're going to do Ooh La La from the Smurfs. So tonight's performers are comprised of students in the Dance Magnet grades 7 through 12, and they are excited to take you to the movies. You to hold on to your seats because the dancers are coming back. I got a little ahead of myself. They did the Michael Jackson tribute first. So you're in for a treat. You're going to see Let's Go to the Movies from Annie, and then you're going to see Ooh La La from the dance company at the middle school. They're the closest thing to Broadway that we have here in Worcester. So now the dance department from Burncoat Middle and Burncoat High School.
Probably crying, while Robert Taylor is locked in a dying embrace.
Chico and Groucho and Chaplin and Loiter all super. Sweet Mickey Mouse, Shirley Temple and Dee.
Light off. Let's go to the movies, Annie, you and me.
Yeah.
Just watching them. what a great group of dancers. And I'm so proud of Miss Sherry and Miss Kelly for putting together this wonderful performance for us tonight. And I'm also thankful. And I'm also very thankful of your support in the lobby of the stars and of the portraits that were done by the eighth graders that you put a silent auction bid on. It really means a lot to the kids. I don't know if you know that much about SOFA, but we do put out a newsletter quarterly, and that goes to all the homes of students in the high school, the middle school, and the Worcester Arts Magnet School. Tells us a little bit about SOFA and the different things that we have done throughout the year, the last 4 years. Some of the things that we've done is we've sponsored students on their trips. We've sponsored by buying or purchasing the tickets for shows to go to, for buses that have taken children to Carnegie Hall, the star money that you've so graciously purchased, that will go toward a student being able to go to the Newsies musical in New York this spring. So there's lots of things that this money goes toward. We're hoping to raise approximately, well, we'd like to do over $3,000. That's a nice little nest egg to put toward some of the things that the students are requesting to do that is not quite in the budget. And it's also good to help out the parents, right? Yes, I know. Okay, so I'm doing a little filling in here because we're setting up for the orchestra, but what I'd like to talk about now is the Burncoat High School String Orchestra. Donnie Ramone is the director, and he is going to perform with his students the concerto for two violins by Bach. Now this is the song that was featured at the end of Music of the Heart, where Meryl Streep starred in it, and it's an absolutely beautiful piece. And we have a little treat for you. We have two violinists that will be performing solos. One is Garrett Levesque, and the other is Matthew Abraham. Matthew is an 11th grader. Thank God we're going to have him next year. And Garrett is a 12th grader who will be moving on. Now, Garrett was tried out for, the district and the state and all the different concerts that they have here in Massachusetts. And he actually made the National Honors Orchestra, which performed in Nashville, Tennessee. There was a wonderful, wonderful article in the Worcester Telegram and Gazette concerning Garrett, and it was wonderful to read, and I was very proud to be connected with the Burncoat Magnet Schools and knowing that he was in our program. So, and then the following, this takes him a while to set up, and then following is David Twiss, and he brings the quadrivium. And he has performed since 2007. He has brought his group to festivals at Carnegie Hall, which SOFA helped to underwrite with your wonderful donations. He's brought them to Disney World, and he's also done backup for Kenny Rogers at Foxwoods when he does his Christmas special. So tonight they're going to do Manor Muppet, Could We Start Again from Jesus Christ Superstar, and Skyfall. If you remember, Adele performed that in the Oscars, and that was in 2012. So I think you have a string orchestra and some wonderful choral work, and I think you'll enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you. myself this question: what's the right direction to go? I don't know.
Just nominated in 1974 for Best Song. And it's from the movie, which is a terrible movie, Jesus Christ Superstar. But it's a wonderful play, it's a terrible movie. And it's a song called Could We Start Again, Please? And it's kind of a throwaway song they threw in there. But I think that Andrew Lloyd Webber, had he used my arrangement of this song, he might actually have a career.
Yeah.
We have one more selection. Before we do that, just to those of you who are new to this event, we hope that you will bring your students, your children, be our students, at Burkhardt Middle and Burkhardt High School. We have wonderful programs up there. And this group is the select course, so they auditioned to be in this course. And since we saw you last year, we took the second highest place at the Disney Honors Festival in Florida. And this year, thank you. This year we're going to Virginia, to Williamsburg Festival at the College of William & Mary. And that will be in April. Now, the last song is this year's Academy Award winner by Adele, and it's from Skyfall.
Thank you.
Oh, I just wanted to tell you this one thing. All the teachers whose groups performed tonight saw me on the side and said, I want you to say this about my group. I want you to say this about my group. They are so proud of their students and the work that they have done. It's like their children. And when their children are out doing things that are good and that are appreciated and the children are growing, the parents are very happy. So you have a parent backstage here with your child, too, that's just as proud as you are. So, at the Burncoat High School, we're fortunate to have a full symphony orchestra. The orchestra plays all over. They perform concerts for a lot of venues, but most recently they performed in New York City at the USS Intrepid, right on the Hudson River. The orchestra is very proud of its alumni, which include a double bass player at the Philharmonic in New York City, and also a professor of music at Harvard. Our students don't just put their instrument down when they leave. They go on to some of the best schools here in New England, the music schools. They go to Berkeley, they go to the Boston University, they go to UNH, UMass, and also the Juilliard School of Music. Our orchestra also is inspired by the affiliation and the partnership that they share with Music Worcester, Apple Hill Chamber Music, and Worcester Chamber Music. So we're not just playing for Burncoat High School, we're playing for the community and beyond. So enjoy the Burncoat Orchestra. On behalf of the SOFA committee, the principals, and the teachers at Burncoat Middle, Burncoat High School, and Worcester Arts Magnet, I want to thank you so much for coming again tonight. I want to thank you for supporting us and for being here and supporting your children. For the finale, I'd like to announce that they're going to be doing When You Believe. It won the 1998 Academy Award for Best Original Song. It was written by Stephen Schwartz, who also wrote Godspell, Wicked, Pippin, and many other Broadway shows and film scores. This song was featured in the animated film The Prince of Egypt. The film tells the story of Moses and the Jewish people he led out of slavery in Egypt. Within the song is the Hebrew text of the Song of the Sea, which ends with the words Ashira, 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 which translates to I will sing, and I will sing. Now the fine arts students of the Burncoat Fine Arts programs will sing and play When You Believe. Thank you.